Camera right there.
Welcome everybody to the ST Joshi Fashion Makeover.
Hey,
what can I do with this face? Hello, girlfriend.
I don't know. Not much you can do here.
You're fabulous the way you are.
Very good, very good.
So what's this?
Well, lots of things are happening. Of course, my life is always very busy with work and things, but I am actually expanding outside the domain of literature to the extent of putting on a film festival. The Seattle Art Museum presents Lovecraft's Visions. Let me see if I can get the dates here. Well, you'll see them. It's October 7th to October 9th.
Got a bit of a shine.
Yeah. Anyway, October 7th to October 9th of this year at the Seattle Art Museum, which is downtown Seattle, they asked me to stage a Lovecraft Film Festival. It's all stuff that, you know, has been seen for the most part. We start, of course, with the first major Lovecraft film, The Haunted Palace, and go through things like The Dunwich Horror, at least one of the Stuart Gordon films. I think we've chosen Reanimator, but we have some exciting, relatively new films that a lot of people haven't seen, in particular, the new film of The Whisperer in Darkness, by the H.P. Lovecraft Historical Society, and those two guys, Sean Branny and Andrew Lehman, will in fact be up here for that event and be on a panel talking about that film. Also, Sean sent me a German film of The Color Out of Space. It's called Die Farbe, which just means the color in German. It is fabulous. It came out last year, or it was finished last year. I don't know the people who did it, but they have done a really superb job. One of the best Lovecraft adaptations you will ever see, and we are very happy to have gotten permission to show that film also. So some new stuff out there that most people
and
haven't seen.
There will be films, and you're doing some panels.
There would be two panel discussions, one on Lovecraft's life and influence. I wish Willem could come to that, but he's otherwise occupied. And then one on the Lovecraft films. And so people like Greg Bear will be there.
Wow.
Mark Laidlaw. Who else? Let me see. My assistant, or rather my partner in this venture, is Jason Brock down in Vancouver. Jason and Sonny Brock have done a lot of the work on this project also, so they'll be there as well, and they'll be on the panels, and you'll get a good look at them also. So that's fun, and we hope to do this every year, not Lovecraft all the time, but in fact next year we're already thinking of doing a Rod Serling Film Festival, showing not only things like, you know, Twilight Zone episodes or Night Gallery episodes, but things like The Planet of the Apes. You know, he wrote the screenplay to that, and a number of other things. Maybe some stuff relating to Charles Beaumont, who was, of course, his colleague, and Richard Matheson, that whole circle called The Group down in California. So that's that, and then the year after that, we hope to have a Poe Film Festival, and then after that will be a lot of fun. We can maybe get Roger Corman up here, although I don't know if that'll happen, but anyway, and then the year after that, we're now talking, 2014, we'll go back to Lovecraft, because there are plenty of other Lovecraft films that could be shown at that time. We haven't. We're only showing a fraction of them. Sorry, that's one of the things I've been doing. On the literary front, Larry Roberts of Bloodletting Press released this book. Let's see if we can get a good look at this. The Crawling Chaos and Others. This is the first volume of the annotated revisions and collaborations of H.P. Lovecraft that I edited. I believe it's from his Arcane Wisdom imprint.
Yep.
It's a fabulous book, and there's only 150 hardcover copies. I think 120 have already been sold, so only 30 left. But it will come out in paperback later. And the second volume, I'm not sure when that's going to come out, but that'll come out probably maybe next spring or thereabouts. The compilation was long finished. Larry Roberts will also now do a two-volume edition of what I called Lovecraft's favorite horror stories. I know that some other books of this sort have been done, but in my humble estimation, my compilation is somewhat superior to those, only because I've chosen stories that Lovecraft not only liked, but was influenced by, ranging from things like, Anthony M. Rudd's story Ooze, which appeared in the first issue of Weird Tales, March 1923, along with things like, Algernon Blackwood's Ancient Sorceries, which clearly had an influence on the Shadow over Innsmouth, and a whole bunch of other things. So I have, commentary explaining Lovecraft's fondness for these stories and how they may have influenced him. So that's coming out. I think the first volume may be out end of this year, I'm not sure. Anyway, that's coming out. I'm also pleased to announce the appearance of one of my first books from Jared Walter's Centipede Press, and that is, let me see if I can get this, Tales of the Grand Guignol by Maurice Lavelle. Now, this is it's going to be an extremely rare hardcover because he only printed 100 copies, but it's a superb volume, I think, of two short novels by Maurice Lavelle, plus every single story, I think, that has appeared in an English translation. Lavelle wrote hundreds and hundreds of stories. They're non-supernatural for the most part, but they're what we would today call psychological suspense. But he was a master at that craft. This is a pretty big volume. It will come out in paperback later from Hippocampus Press, okay. Maybe next year or the year after. But so this is the first edition, though, limited 100 copies.
And you have a new book out from the Library of America.
Yes, the Library of America just finally published my edition of Ambrose Bierce, and I was very happy to see that, and it's gotten good reviews all over the place. It got reviewed in the Wall Street Journal,
wow.
Very nice. In I think the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel wrote a review, and I think a Tampa Bay newspaper as well. So that's out there. But I'm particularly interested in my edition of Arthur Machen from Penguin.
Mm.
It's called The White People and Other Stories. It should be out any time now. I think the official release date is early October.
Fantastic.
It's a great, yeah, it's a great cover. And I also got a nice foreword by Guillermo del Toro, who is a very sensitive writer and knows the field. Penguin has set up a reading or discussion for this book at the University of Washington Bookstore on October 17th, which is a Monday, I believe. So anybody in the Seattle area should try to come to that, because that'll be a lot of fun to chew the fat about Arthur Machen, who doesn't get talked about nearly as much as he should. It took me like a decade, I think, to persuade Penguin to issue an Arthur Machen book, and they only did it really if I could guarantee that I could get the preface by by Del Toro, which I did, and he was very happy to write it and wrote a beautiful piece. And apparently, Penguin is also issuing a sort of a special edition of my first Penguin Lovecraft book, The Call of Cthulhu and other weird stories. Apparently as part of their commemoration of the 75th anniversary of Penguin Books. I believe there's a siren going off nearby here. Anyway, and Willem has just shown me the cover. It's already out there online. I don't know when the actual print edition
I've
will come out.
I pre-ordered it on Amazon already.
Yeah, it looks like a fabulous cover. I don't know who the artist is, but it's...
Well, we can find out right now.
All right. It's some Travis Louie.
Travis Louie.
It's some person named Travis Louie, who I don't know, but he's done a fabulous cover, and so that'll be out. I'm not sure what else will be different about it aside from the cover, but I'm glad they chose that. I could have sworn they also wanted to release my Lord Dunsany edition, Penguin edition, which is called In the Land of Time and Other Fantasy Tales. Because I think to their surprise, that book has also done quite well. It took me a while to persuade them to do that too, but that seems to have gotten good sales for them as well.
Okay. We want to say a special shout out to Mike Davis, who edits the Lovecraft e-zine. It went on hiatus for a bit, but the new issue came out today. It's available online. And there you can read new Lovecraft fiction for free, and some of it's...
That's right.
Some of it's very good.
Mm-hmm.
I write a monthly vignette. It's a brand new vignette every month, and for me as a writer, it's a great outlet, because sometimes I just can't work on the book that I'm trying to work on, so this gives me an outlet to have something out there. And the stories are usually really great. So, Mike, we are glad to see the easing is back online, and this new issue looks really fabulous.
Yeah, I was, you know, Willem just showed it to me. I'm embarrassed to say I have not heard of it before, but I'm not really out there. I don't really scan the web to see what's out there in the Lovecraft world, but I was very impressed with this website, and it's has lots of stuff, and it's free, I'll tell you. I mean, can't go wrong. Not only the fiction, but a lot of news items and video and audio and all sorts of other
all
stuff.
Really great.
So yeah, that's yeah. I think that the actual URL is lovecraftzine.com. So look for that anyway. Good stuff.
And he has a fan page on Facebook. So, but it just it's really worthwhile. So do check out The Lovecraft E-Zine by Mike Davis, and he's got some really great people that are helping him out financially and stuff, so we want to salute them as well. You usually use the web just for study, research?
Yeah, for research purposes. As I say, I...
Except when you come see me, girlfriend.
That's right. Well, you know, many of you know probably that I actually had a Facebook page, but I think I got so many friend invitations that I kind of freaked out and
ours
that's
friends
right. Yeah so
my
I
God.
So I took my page down. It's I'm sorry to say it's not my kind of thing. I do have a website
our
good friend Greg Lowney runs for me because I'm too incompetent
Greg is
to do
our
it myself
hero. He actually
and I do
set up your website.
Yeah, he's done the whole thing, and I do a blog every maybe 2 or 3 weeks. I'd like to do it more often, but I'm actually trying to do work, you know, so I can't write about my work unless I do some of it. so I'd like to do my blog more often, but you know, I send it to Greg and he posts it, and now I'll tell you, we set up a new page just listing all my forthcoming books, and it's frighteningly long. My God, I have like 20 books coming out in the next year and a half or thereabouts. Anywhere from a new edition of Mencken's plays, of all things. He wrote a bunch of plays, including a full-length play called Heliogabalus about the decadent Roman emperor. Hilarious play. To you know, to all this stuff from Centipede Press and from Larry Roberts's press, and the Hippocampus, of course, always coming out. We are still hoping. Well, this year from Hippocampus, we're on the verge of finishing the Lovecraft Letters to James F. Morton, a big, big book, nearly 500 pages long, a major addition to the collection of Lovecraft letters that we're starting.
What's up with the Clark Ashton Smith?
We are going to do that next. The joint correspondence of Lovecraft and Clark Ashton Smith. We hope to get that out end of next year, but that's going to be another two volumes, and we hope we can get the editing done by then. That's going to be major. We don't have all the letters by either side, but we have enough to make it a very rich correspondence.
Now, are you guys bringing out the 3 poetry volumes in paperback, or is that not feasible?
What poetry volumes?
Of Clark Ashton Smith.
Yes, we are. The that is on schedule. I'm not sure when that's going to happen, but the Clark Ashton Smith poetry edition will, in fact, come out in paperback, as will... I think the Lovecraft Robert E. Howard letters is already out in paperback.
Yes, it is.
And I thought we're working on the Lovecraft letters to August Derleth in a paperback edition also, because again, that was also a pretty limited hardcover edition of 200, 250, or 300.
You can buy them on Amazon for $1,000.
What, the hardcovers?
For the set, yeah.
Oh my God.
We're both of Derleth and Howard.
Don't do that. The paperbacks will be coming. But yeah, it's the problem with that is we had to negotiate all over again with the rights owners for the paperbacks, because our initial contract covered only the hardcover, so we had to go all the way back and, you know, run through their hoops once again. But it'll happen. And I'm still hoping my collected edition of the poetry of George Sterling. I know a lot of people out there don't maybe not care for George Sterling and certainly don't want 3 volumes of it, but it's one of my lifelong projects. I fell in love with George Sterling's poetry when I first read it years ago, and this has been a dream come true with it. So I'm very grateful for Derek Hussey of Hippocampus Press to indulge me in this matter. It's all his money.
And David E. Schultz.
He's my co-editor on this. And he formats all the Hippocampus Press books and does a beautiful job at it. So
one day David's going to bring us the annotated fungi from Yucca.
Yes. If he can ever find the time, he works... crushing amount of work at his office. He does have a day job, unlike...
He says you're a real slave
driver. Yeah. We, you know, see, we're a bunch of loafers here. We don't have a day job, so So I think we're just about running out of time here.
We are.
But anyway, so lots of things always happening. Check my website, check Willem's various YouTube things, and there we are.